India is a land of festivals. Holi, Ganesh Utsav, Navratri, Diwali, and film festivals, such as the International Film Festival of India, where it is season time to take offense at artistically made movies. Are you offended by a film which shows the life and struggle of a woman who poses nude for art students so she can support her family? Are you offended by the title of a film called Sexy Durga, although the film has nothing to do with the Hindu goddess? And are you offended by a hint of romance between fictional Padmavati and Alauddin Khilji? Are you trying either online or offline to stop these films from being screened? If yes, the artist's freedom of expression is under threat in India. Most protests, like the one against Sanjay Leela Bhansali's Padmavati, are on the basis of
He is not taking religious sentiments.
Is the same catchphrase used by Muslims too. Bhansali is not a historian making a documentary that demands accuracy.
Making a movie and his purpose is to entertain.
The Supreme Court has also taken a similar stand and asked the CBFC to decide.
The rights of a filmmaker cannot be curtailed. The court should be extremely slow to curb the artist's freedom.
Instead, he's had to voluntarily delay the release of his film.
I will hold a screening for the protesters to prove there is nothing offensive in the film.
There is one sure way to find out if Padmavati really existed in history or whether she was an imaginary person. The attack on Chittor was in 1303, while Jayasi wrote Padmavati in 1540. There are many historical documents after 1540 about Padmavati, but if a document exists that is dated between 1303 and 1540, then she can be said to have really existed. Also, why is there no protest against mindless violence, gore and glorification of crime? Isn't that as bad? At the 48th International Film Festival of India in Goa,
we have all decided that the festival will open with a Marathi film.
But days before the festival,
nude and S. Durga have been dropped.
In protest, jury chairman Sujay Ghosh resigned, along with jury members Apurva Asrani and Gyan Koria. Sasi Dharan's S. Durga, or previously named, had earned the wrath of some permanent protesters, claiming it, you guessed it, hurt religious sentiments because it demeaned their goddess. But the film has nothing to do with the Hindu goddess. Durga is only the name of the lead character.
S. Durga is a thriller which deals with the dangers faced by a couple taking a lift from strangers.
They justified the dropping of these films by giving a lame excuse.
Only two films have been dropped. Why aren't people focusing instead that 18 have been left untouched?
That's like saying,
I only dropped two babies. What about the 18 babies I didn't drop? Focus on that.
Going on to further say that the films were dropped to protect the sensitivities of viewers. Maybe the government will next ban us from visiting the temples of Khajuraho? Marcel, a Tamil thriller released in October 2017, criticized demonetization and GST and also faced a ban.
Singapore pays 7% GST and all citizens get free medical. Why should India pay 18%?
Last year it was Edile Mushkil because of Pakistani actor Fawad Khan, forcing filmmaker Karan Johar to compromise.
I promise not to work with Pakistani artists in the future. I have to compromise as the effort of hundreds of people will get wasted.
CBFC chief Prasoon Joshi is the man who may end up deciding on Padmavati and what the limits of artistic freedom could be in our country.
We will take a balanced view and we need time to decide.
Meanwhile, the Kerala High Court has now put the INB ministry in a spot.
S. Durga should be screened at the ongoing Goa Film Fest.
Will the government obey the Kerala High Court order? Will Padmavati be certified by CBFC? Important times ahead for the future of our country. This bows limerick. Can an artist speak freely or not? And make up a fantastical plot without being beaten or otherwise threatened? Is it okay to stir the pot?
If you like this video, share it with your friends and become BizBo's friend by subscribing for free to BizBo's YouTube channel.